lot of your work in the laboratory will involve you using reagents to accomplish a task. And the reagents will often come in concentrations or at a state that you cannot use as is. So for instance, if you want to go and lyse some cells or lyse some tissues or prepare reagents that will break open cells or tissues so that you can extract the components in order to study it, you may need to make what is called a lysis buffer. And this will have components that will indeed break open a cell. And the breaking open of the cell can be in a gentle way so that you can only, you break open only specific components of the cell, or in a harsh way that breaks everything open because you're going to extract everything. And so in these scenarios, you often need to make the reagent that you need to use maybe communicated to you in terms of a percent solution, or it may be in terms of a molar concentration. So percent solutions are really easy to calculate, but if you don't understand what the convention is, then it may be confusing. So a percent solution, whenever you're told to go make a percent solution, this is referring to gram quantities per 100 milliliters, where the reagent is not a solid but a liquid, such as a detergent that you need to use to make a certain percentage of, then it's not gram per 100 milliliters but milliliters per 100 milliliters. So for instance, if we want to make an 80% solution and our reagent that we're weighing out is a solid, like a salt, like tris in a buffer, then we, when we see 80%, what we need to think of is 80 gram in every 100 milliliters. If it's a liquid, like we've got twin, the detergent twin 20 that we need to make in our reagent, then the 80%, when we see that, should translate to 80 milliliters in every 100 milliliters. Let's do it again. Say it's a 70% solution. When we see that, if we're thinking of a liquid, then it's 70 milliliters in every 100 milliliter volume. Percentage automatically means per 100. And so if it's a solid, if the reagent we're about to use is a solid, then it's 70 grams per 100 milliliter volume. So say I don't want 100 milliliters because maybe I've only got one plate of cells. I only need, say, 1 milliliter to make the lysis buffer. I only need 1 milliliter to be able to achieve my task. Well, you're not just always going to make a certain gram per 100 milliliters. You will go ahead and adjust accordingly. So say I want to make a lysis buffer, and what I need, the reagent that I need, requires me to make it at 0.5%. Say I'm using a detergent called sodium deoxycholate, and what for my preparation, I need it at 0.5%. Now, all I have to think about is that I want 0.5 in every 100 milliliters. Percent means per 100. Per 100. And so if you always remember this, then you can scale as you need to. Scale the amount that you need according to 100 milliliters. So I want 0.5%. It means I want 0.5 in every 100 milliliters. Now, I only need 1 milliliter because I don't have a lot of cells to prepare, or I don't have whatever I'm doing. I don't need 100 milliliters. So let's scale that. Some other detergents that are used routinely in the laboratory include Triton X100, or you may be using Twin 20, and these are different strengths of detergents. And the volume that you may typically make in microliter volume, of course milliliters, rarely you would need liter volumes, right? If you're making big washing buffers, for instance, then you may need to make liter volumes. And so, of course, if I'm making microliter volumes, I would have to scale it according to the 100 milliliter standard volume that a percent solution refers to. And of course, if I'm making liter volumes, then I'll also have to scale that. So in this example, the experiment that I'm doing, I need 15 microliters per sample that I'm processing, and I actually have 23 samples. So you would times 15 microliters by 23. However, it's always a good idea to give a little bit extra volume, because while you're pipetting, you may lose some. The accuracies of the pipette may vary, and so you wouldn't have exactly the volume you need for all 23 samples. So I will scale it so that I have 25 samples worth. So I'll just times 15 microliters by 25, and I know in total I would need 375 microliters of the detergent at 0.5% for my experiment. However, to make matters easy, I'm actually just going to make a milliliter of the reagent. So I am making excess, a lot extra, but I'm not wasting too much reagent. So we're gonna go ahead and just make a milliliter worth. So the easiest way to go about it is, you know, you want 0.5%, which is the same as I want 0.5 in every 100. And so I'm going to divide 0.5 by 100. And so we adjust by going 0.5 divide by 100, and that just sets it to the amount that I would take per 1 milliliter. And so I go ahead and multiply it by the volume that I want, which is 1 milliliter. And so it's 0.005 milliliters, which gives us 5 microliters of the reagent to be dissolved in your solution that you're using. Dissolve it. But hey, why did I start this video with a dozen eggs in the frame? Well, that was to communicate the idea of molar concentration, which is what the solutions, the reagents that you need to make may be communicated in. And so join me over in the other video where I will go over how to work out molar concentrations. All right, take care. All the best with your experiments.